Learning a new skill may often be challenging, yet over time, the skill becomes easier and easier to perform. We learn in a variety of ways, like via traditional mechanisms, such as instruction-based learning. We also learn from experiences, like learning that whenever someone does not memorize their lines for a school play, they end up looking like a jackass. So today on Brief Brain Facts, we're exploring what Katy Perry referred to as the new plastic surgery. But before we do, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and if you find this video entertaining, don't forget to hit that like button. So without further ado, let's talk about neuroplasticity. Our brains are equipped with the ability to learn. What's more impressive is that we are capable of learning throughout our entire lives, and our brains adapt or adjust to this learning. The idea that the brain can change based on experiences, such as exposure to new stimuli and learning, is neuroplasticity. Or better, neuroplasticity describes the nervous system's ability to modify or change based on multiple time-dependent procedures. It is a complex process by which changes may occur on multiple levels, such as changes to the cells and structure. It may seem as no surprise that our brains are capable of adapting to new experiences. Ultimately, we continue to learn new things throughout our lives, but swift and more direct learning has been noted in children, which account for acquiring new skills, such as understanding of language and mathematics. However, thanks to Ramon Santiago y Cajal, who wrote in 1928 that the brain's neural pathways in adults were fixed, ended, and immutable, the concept that the brain is capable of creating new neural connections, and possibly even new brain cells, although this is still hotly debated, based on new experiences, is a surprisingly new concept. During the majority of the 20th century, neuroscientists believed that the adult brain was incapable of making changes, such as changes to neurons and their connections. Yet, in the 1980s, the concept of a static adult brain began to wane. It was during this time that researchers began to find that new cells were added in adult brains to the hippocampus, an area of the brain associated with memory. However, this type of brain change, the creation of new brain cells, remains a heavily debated subject. While current exercise regimens and diets may claim to boost cell growth in certain areas of the brain, this may not be the case, especially since those claims have not been scientifically verified. Recent evidence shows that neurogenesis, or the creation of new brain cells, specifically within the hippocampus, does not occur within the brains of human adults. This study is unique in that not only does it rely on human brains, unlike other studies that have used other animal models, but also it is one of the largest studies designed to inspect neurogenesis within the hippocampus. Even if new brain cells in the adult brain are incapable of developing, neurogenesis differs from neuroplasticity, as neuroplasticity involves the wiring of connections between those cells in order for communication to occur across the brain. Neuroplasticity occurs in three main ways, the most obvious being childhood development. Humans are born with more synapses and brain cells than they need as adults. As children, our brains need to learn as much as possible. As such, our brain goes into overdrive, learning every word, sound, danger, face, and more all at once. During this stage of human development, scientists note that a 3-year-old's brain has about 15,000 connections for a single neuron. Over time, some connections are used more than others. Our brain needs to be as efficient as possible. So, if there is a wasted connection, it is turned off. The brain does this by simply severing the connections, a process called synaptic pruning. The brain may also maximize efficiency by allowing unused cells to die, a process called apoptosis. Just as humans' natural course of development results in neuroplasticity, neuroplasticity also arises from learning and memory. And it is here where neurogenesis and neuroplasticity overlap. Here, neuroplasticity also assumes a changeable brain, and that the brain is possible of change throughout our lives based on experience, as is assumed under neurogenesis. Learning is defined as the capability of acquiring new knowledge that was created via experience. Memory is the storage of that obtained knowledge. Both structural and cellular changes to the synapses of neurons due to knowledge acquisition and storage take place in the brains of adults. The final way in which neuroplasticity occurs in the brain accounts for how people with traumatic brain injuries, TBI, are capable of learning compensatory mechanisms and adjust to sudden deficits that may arise due to injury. Brain rewiring, or creating connections among neurons in the brain, occurs not only when learning, but also when relearning. Consider a commute to work or school. Certain roadways are used to get from point A to point B. Suddenly, a main route has been blocked indefinitely. Other than creating an intense amount of road rage to which the world has never known, adjustments need to be made in order to reach the final destination point by finding a new way to get to point B from point A. And no, you have no GPS to use for navigation, and you don't have a mobile device to phone up a friend to help guide you through LAX that one time you almost missed your flight to Vancouver. Well, this new path needed involves trial and error, like dead ends, U-turns, K-turns, whatever. Finally, a discovery of an effective route that has enabled the commuter to get from point A to point B has been made. Eventually, this route becomes easier and easier to navigate. This too is how the brain is rewired, and the strengthening of connections between cells via learning occurs. The streets act as connections between cells. The roadblock is a sudden injury to the brain, while the commuter acts as the signal that is being trained to complete a course, which, over time, produces a change to the brain based on those travel patterns. In due time, this brain change helps compensate for lost function. Thus, neuroplasticity allows us to learn new information, even as adults. The brain can create new connections among existing cells, as it is rewired to account for new learning. So, thanks to neuroplasticity, with enough time and patience, you can definitely teach older brains new tricks. Because if nothing else, humans, while maybe not liking change, are certainly capable of adapting to it. Have you ever heard of the brain changing, and would you consider naturally occurring changes to be a form of plastic surgery? Comment below. If you liked what you saw, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. And head over to our Patreon page for updates and perks for our members. And as always, thank you for watching.